an image appeared on May 15th with a mysterious kill mark of an Mi-24 Hind on a Growler deployed aboard the aircraft carrier USS Dwight D. Eisenhower. The War Zone, in an article, stated that the U.S. Navy confirmed that one of its EA-18G Growler electronic warfare aircraft used an AARGM-88E Advanced Anti-Radiation Guided Missile AARGM to destroy the Mi-24 Hind attack helicopter. However, AARGM is not meant for this kind of attack, since it's primarily a weapon designed to neutralize air defense systems. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how AARGM from USS Dwight D. Eisenhower-based EA-18G Growler destroyed an Mi-24. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Mi-24, also known as the Hind, is a large, heavily armed combat and attack helicopter developed by the Soviet Union during the Cold War. It was designed to provide air support to ground forces and attack enemy armored vehicles and fortifications. The Mi-24 entered service in 1972 and has been used in various military conflicts and operations worldwide, including Russia and Ukraine. It's been used in various military conflicts and operations, including the Soviet War in Afghanistan, the Gulf War, and the Syrian Civil War. Several foreign forces have used it, including India, Iraq, and Syria. While newer platforms have largely supplanted its role, the Soviet-era Mi-24 helicopter continues to see active service in numerous regions worldwide. Two powerful Isotov TV-3 117 VMA turboshaft engines give it a top speed of about 200 miles per hour, or 320 kilometers per hour, and a maximum range of over 500 miles, or 805 kilometers. The helicopter has 6 suspension weapon units on the wingtips. Mi-24 can be extensively armed and has many weapons that can be adapted to meet mission requirements. These include a 30mm cannon, missile pods, anti-tank missiles, and other weapons. It was believed that the Mi-24 was operated by Iranian-backed Houthi militants. The Houthi movement, colloquially simply Houthis, is an Islamist political and armed organization that emerged from the Yemeni governorate of Sada in the 1990s. Since the outbreak of the Hamas-Israel conflict in October 2023, Houthi rebels controlling western Yemen have been launching a mix of drones and missiles to show their support for Hamas, first targeting Israel before redirecting their fire at civilian and military shipping off the coast of Yemen. This is why the Mi-24 was targeted. AGM-88E AARGM is an anti-radiation missile. Anti-radiation missiles are designed as a counter to advanced air defense systems. This kind of missile is built to detect and home in on an enemy radio emission source. Typically, these are designed for use against an enemy radar, although jammers and even radios used for communications can also be targeted in this manner. This type of missile is commonly carried by specialist aircraft in the Suppression of Enemy Air Defenses (SEAD) role. The primary purpose of this type of missile is to degrade enemy air defenses in the first period of a conflict in order to increase the chances of survival for the following waves of strike aircraft. Radars are like eyes of the air defense, and once it's taken out, it becomes severely handicapped. Often, SEAD escort aircraft also carry cluster bombs, which can be used to ensure that after the ARM disables the SAM system's radar, the command post, missile launchers, and other components or equipment are also destroyed to guarantee that the SAM site stays down. AARGM offers improved capabilities over the HARM or high-speed anti-radiation missile system it replaces. The AARGM features new software and enhanced capabilities to counter jamming through electronic warfare. Previous versions of the missile could be dodged by turning off the radar before the weapon could lock onto their signals. AARGM contains a multi-mode guidance package containing a GPS-assisted inertial navigation system, as well as a millimeter wave radar that can locate targets even if they stop emitting radio frequency or other signals or even begin to move. The standoff precision strikes capability enables the AARGM to serve a secondary role as a rapid response weapon against non-air defense-related targets. In other words, it can quickly strike ground targets that do not emit radiation over long distances. In this case, the U.S. Navy's kill chain or pre-mission intelligence identified the Mi-24, leading to the deployment of the AARGM to destroy it while it was on the ground. The missile navigated using GPS INS and then homed in on the target with its millimeter wave radar seeker. Before the war with the Saudi-led Arab coalition, the Yemeni Air Force had several Mi-24 Hind derivatives. Initially, it was believed that these helicopters were either destroyed or rendered completely unserviceable during the conflict. However, other reports indicate that a small number of them have seen action in recent years. It's important that any asset that Houthis can use to cause harm be destroyed. The mission showcased the unique secondary capabilities of AARGM. When it comes to the larger picture, the situation seems to be improving. Greek shipping minister Christos Stylianides told Reuters in an interview a few days ago that closer international cooperation between naval missions in the Red Sea has reduced the number of attacks by Yemen's Houthis over the past week. Viewers may note that Greece is the home of the headquarters of the European Union's naval operation in the Red Sea. It remains to be seen if the Houthis can be kept at bay.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.